last part from here, which is the part 2 of biofuels and bioplastic. I would like to divert your attention to another aspect. Everybody in this world is acquainted with plastic or polyethylene, and we use it every day in our daily life. Albeit, we know that it has been destructing our Mother Earth for so many decades. I suppose a question might arise in your mind that why I am relating the concept of biodiesel to that of plastic. Of course, there is a rigid thread of connection. Let me explain it to you. In an article of the Statesman newspaper, in the science part, Mr. Swaswato R. Das, plastic, that does double duty as biofuel. In his describing, the writer has noted that Dr. Richard Gross and colleagues at the Polytechnic Institute of New York University have successfully produced a bioplastic similar to conventional polyethylene that does double duty. That is, one can use it in the form of biofuel even after its conventional use ceases. The writer has also pointed out its origination by the researchers when Dr. Gross commenced with vegetable oil consisting of fatty acids, which were fermented by the engineered cells from the yeast Candida tropicalis into W-hydroxy fatty acids, which in turn were processed into a polyethylene-like bioplastic. Thus, when this bioplastic ceases its application, it can be broken down using an enzyme called cutinase, which is made by the parasites such as fungi, Fusarium solani, to break down the tough cuticle protecting the surface of leaves. Mr. Das has also put forward Dr. Gross' suggestions, according to which the plastic needs to be shredded and immersed in lukewarm water to facilitate the enzyme process. The conversion will take 3 to 4 days to break down all the plastic into biodiesel. So, is this not a technological development forward to supplant the use of polythene? Of course, there are other biodegradable polymers like muriel produced by metabolites, but its cost is a factor that matters mainly. Dr. Gross estimates the cost of this bioplastic to be around $1.40 to $1.50 per pound. I suppose that if this kind of bioplastic propinquies to use by most of the people of this world, including us, then neither of the repercussions that we are facing today has to be confronted. I entirely agree with what our benevolent Father John Thwaites has said in his video, that love is the only panacea for every hindrance of an individual. Thank you.